Here is 30 2018 Shelby GT350. It has MP concept headlights. I think it's running hot. This is a wrap with black stripes. I don't mind it. I don't like the stripes so much. Wrap is a little old. You can tell in certain areas. The wheels got some signature SV302 something sitting on some Yokohama. What do you guys want to call it? I think it looks good. The wheels. I got the clear Euros. Trunk's gonna be dirty, but does have full Hertz audio system, they said, JL, which I need to fix. It cuts out about 50% volume. Dirty stuff in here, guys, don't mind. But it's got the Recaro's, Caro's full nav system. They have a lot of carbon in here. I don't like the carbon in the dash. This ain't bad. The MGW short throw. I mean, it's basic interior, you know? But need to get the windshield tinted. Too bright, nothing in there. But I also consider myself a bit short, so seat is almost all the way up. No, I'm just kidding, it's not all the way up, but the seat's pumped all the way down, and so I can push the clutch all the way in, no issue. Driving a 2018 Shelby GT350 here. Consider a full bolt on. It's got stainless works headers. There's definitely cats on it, guys. Resonator delete with a X pipe. JLT cold air intake. Solar performance throttle body, which, if I'm not mistaken, those are just the stock throttle body, just ported out larger. It's got stock intake manifold, not ported, so 350 manifold. I'll show you guys the outside of the car here, you know, later, but it's sitting on some signature SV302s, I believe. It's got an MGW short throw. Trying to think of what else we got here. Whole car's wrapped in a like forest green with black stripes. Original color is the metallic gray. I don't know the exact color, but it's a gray. There's a couple suspension things done. You got the basic bushings done on the frame. It's got sway front and rear sway bars sitting on some lowering springs. Various things. So I bought this thing used with 33,000 miles on it about 10 days ago, and I am at 34,700. I'm driving a little bit. It's got a 93 octane tune on it from Juggernaut Performance. There is also a flex fuel tune for the car by them as well. Honestly, it runs kind of shitty. I'm probably gonna go to a local shop that I brought previous vehicles to and get them dyno tuned, do a 93 and a straight 85, not a flex tune, so I can have an option between the two. I was looking at 85 control module a lot of people use for these. I can't think of the name of it right now. But a lot of people use that, and they get their car tuned on 93, and then they run that, and it corrects it for you. So you can just keep your 93 tuned and not have to switch back to 85. It didn't seem half bad, but I don't know exactly how that works, so probably just get both tunes, dyno tune. Like I said, idle's kind of choppy in this thing, but overall drivability, I don't have any issues with the drivability while I'm going. It just seems to idle pretty shitty, you know, very low RPMs. But I did contact Juggernaut Performance, gave them the VIN, and asked them what they tuned for. And those couple people I know, little pull there. Windows. Hopefully the wind wasn't too bad on that. Yeah, a couple people I know on the bikes probably going to the place I usually go in the downtown area here, where I'm from. But like I said, it probably runs, I think it runs kind of shoddy here at low RPMs due to that throttle body. Like I said, I reached out to Juggernaut Performance, and they told me it was tuned. They said they just tuned it for headers and cold air intake. So they didn't tune it for a larger throttle body, which I know for a fact that's going to affect, you know, your low RPM drivability and idling. What else is there? Yeah, I don't know. I think there's a couple things that could have been that it could have been tuned for, which increase a little bit of drivability there. So yeah, I'm just gonna bring it to their shop. I'm gonna do a good maintenance on it this week. I haven't really done anything. I just checked oil, made sure that was all good. I am burning up. I'm turning AC on. The car sounds completely different to it idle with AC on, which obviously that's normal. Yeah. It's a used car. It's a 2018. So what's that? That's 6 years old now. So there's car's been around for a little bit. Miles aren't terrible for the year. The wrap, I don't know exactly how old the wrap is on the car. I can tell it's kind of old just because the condition of it. So I'm gonna keep it there on as long as I can for right now, and then probably do a new wrap. I love the color. I've had two Bullet Mustangs, so it's a very similar color to that. This does have some MP Concept headlights. One of them is bad. The actual projector light is not working, and I looked at them. You can't actually even replace the projector lights, all in one unit. So I'm probably gonna buy some new headlights. I was thinking about doing, I don't want to do stock ones. I don't mind them, but I don't want to do the stocks if I'm switching anyways. They have the S650 style now with like the three cubes with a perimeter running light on it. I like those. This does have some clear Euros on it. They look pretty good. So, I mean, overall, I mean, not a whole lot of cosmetically to fix or mechanically. Just, I think just a new tune. And then when that wrap does eventually pretty much fall off completely, I'm praying the paint's good under this thing. So honestly, I don't know, it's wrapped, so I'm gonna pray it's a good paint and either run the paint, just, you know, factory OEM paint on it, or regardless, good or bad, I think I might get another wrap on it. Looking at, I mean, you know, half the time if it's bad paint underneath the a wrap or a clear bra or, you know, whatever it may be, most of the time I feel like you can see any defects if they're major. Not like, I mean, minor scratches you might not be able to see that aren't deep, but as far as like deep gouges that wouldn't be able to be buffed out,
I think you'd be able to notice them with the rev. And I did like a good once over. I didn't really see anything that stood out to me. But yeah, I'm thinking about doing some POV drives. I'm going to a Cars and Coffee this weekend with a couple of my buddies. Actually, some of those people that were on the bikes that drove past a little bit ago. A couple cars. And then we have like where it's going. It's kind of like a windy road, back road type feel. So I'll probably throw a camera on for that. Do some just POV driving. Get something used to. Hopefully this angle works out. You guys, if you are sticking around, appreciate it. If you guys want to see more of the vehicle, I will be doing, you know, a bunch of videos, so you have to definitely subscribe. Like the video if you can. Help me out. It's something I've been wanting to do, and I'm just pushing myself to do it now. It's something I always, no reason, just didn't push myself to do it, even though there's, it doesn't take but a couple minutes to throw a camera on, and then, you know, an hour or so to fucking edit a video. So, I said, screw it. We're going for it, finally. I just picked this car up and, you know, got rid of my old one. So, starting from scratch, brand new vehicle. Well, new to me. And it's probably not the best time to be cruising around. I got everyone getting off work. It's like 6 o'clock, 6 p.m. around here, so you know. Got rush hour. I'm just pretty much sitting here yapping about nothing. One thing I do have to say, obviously you guys haven't seen the outside of this car, but one thing I have to do is to say, out of every car I've had, this one definitely gets the most attention. Just driving around, all those head turns. Oh, that, and whoever drove this car before, it was definitely beat on 100%. Clutch definitely slips first and second gear pretty bad. I've done a couple digs. From, you know, leaf stop, and you can feel this, the clutch slipping, getting hot. But it does hook still. I shouldn't say hook. Car does not hook. And you get new tires as well. Probably throw about, including tune and everything, probably throw about $2,000 in this thing for some maintenance and some things they'd be fixed, and I think it'd be good. Pretty much all set with there, and I wouldn't worry about too much more anymore after that. Camaro up here, ZL1? Probably. Like the color. Don't know if you guys can see that angle. It's a nice color. I've always had full exhaust, you know, headers all the way to a cabback. My last two cars, absolutely obnoxious with, you know, Cooks. I had Cooks 2-inch headers with Gorse Extreme on a 5.0. Absolutely scream no matter what. This, I'm surprised how loud this is. So, like I said to you earlier, it's definitely, there's definitely cats on it, guys, I promise. EPA is watching. And then, stainless works, 1 7/8 to just a X-pipe with factory active exhaust on it. Sounds really good, I think. Definitely sounds different from outside, obviously quite given, but behind it, it sounds so much better from outside. A couple videos been sent to me, and it screams. There is a check engine light if you guys see that. Maybe from the headers. I need to get some Fowlers to extend the O2 sensors a bit. And then I should be able to get rid of that check engine light.